In this lesson, we're going to be adding multileaders to a drawing. A multileader object typically consists of an arrowhead, a horizontal landing, a leader line or curve, and either a multiline text object or a block. AutoCAD comes with several predefined blocks which can be used with multileaders, or you can define your own block to be used with a multileader. If you're using mText, you can assign the desired text style to be used by the mText object. I'm going to start by defining a multileader style to be used for my item balloons. To define the ML leader style, I use the expanded area on the annotation panel on the home ribbon. I select the ML leader style tool. I already have a few styles defined in my drawing. If I want to see what they look like, I can highlight the style name, and the preview window displays a preview of the style. I select the New button. I type Item Balloon for my style name. I press Continue. I select the Content tab. I set my multileader type to use a block. You can see that I have the choice of using a block, mText, or none. I select the circle as my source block. I change my scale to 2, and you see the preview adjusts to the new scale. I press OK. I verify that the current multileader style is set to item balloon. I press Close. My mLeader command is located on the annotation panel on the home ribbon. I select the mLeader tool from the ribbon. I right-click and select Options. Notice that I can change the leader type, the leader landing, the content type, the number of points used, or the angles applied when creating my leader. I select the leader type option. The leader type is currently set to straight, as this is how I define my style. I'm going to change it to spline, just to see what that looks like. I exit the options. AutoCAD prompts me to place my arrowhead location. I pick in my window to place the arrowhead for my leader. I want to make sure ortho is set to off, as that can interfere with the placement of the leaders. I select the location for the block, and the attribute dialog appears. I type in the number 5. I'm going to place another multileader for the cable. I right-click and select Repeat mLeader. I place my multileader. Notice that this multileader uses the definition of the mLeader style. I want to collect the two item balloons so they are together. I go up to the ribbon and I select the Collect tool located in the mLeader drop-down list. I select the two multileaders and then pick in the window to place the collected multileaders. Notice the style that's used by the collected multileaders. I'm going to place the additional multileaders I want for this drawing. I right-click and select Recent Input and select the mLeader command. I place the additional multileaders using the item numbers shown in the parts list. I want to add additional leaders to one of the item balloons to indicate additional parts. I can use the Add Leader tool from the ribbon. I select the multileader to be modified and place the additional desired leaders. I press Enter to exit the command. I placed a leader to the wrong component. It needs to be removed. I select the Remove Leader tool from the ribbon. I select the mLeader to be modified. I select the leader to be removed. I press Enter. I want to align my leaders. I select the Align tool from the ribbon. I select the multileaders I want to align. I can use a window or a crossing to select my multileaders. I right-click and select Options. I select the Distribute option. I then select the first multileader to align to. I use my cursor to position and align the multileaders. And then I pick to select my desired positioning. In this lesson, we reviewed the multileader tools. You learned how to create a multiline style, how to change a multileader on the fly using options, how to combine two or more multileaders using the collect tool, how to add and remove leaders, and how to align your multileaders so your drawing looks cleaner.